Am I leading this? How are we doing this?
I don't know. I thought about this all effing weekend.
So did I, and I never came to a conclusion on how to do this. Hey, look, there comes a time in everyone's life where they need to take the next step in their life, right? You got to leap. If you don't leap, you know, nothing ventured, nothing gained. You got to take that leap sometime.
He who dares wins. No moss gathers on a rolling stone, however the hell you want to put it.
If you don't take the risk, you never know.
You never know. Yeah. And our amazing, illustrious producer, the greatest producer in all of radio, in my opinion.
Yeah, coast to coast, the greatest producer this place has ever known, the greatest producer any radio station could ever hope to have, is...
He was offered an opportunity. And we all agree, Justin, myself, and Spiegel, that if he did not take this opportunity, he would be stupid.
You'd be a dum-dum if you didn't say yes to this. So, Mike
Anderson. As much as it breaks our hearts, and as much as we kind of hate him for making this decision, we all understand, correct?
Yes.
Yep.
And
Mike, do you know I got this news? I got it the day, the effing day, because I can't have anything good in my life without a damn black cloud flying overhead. Is the day I started the Friday Night Fiasco. Within an hour of me getting ready to go do that, I get a call, the hot call from you know who, going, "Hey, heads up, hope you're sitting down."
So Mike will be moving on from 98 Rock. And look, hey, come on,
Mike.
It's a sad day, and it's going to, you know, it's going to be, there's going to be, you know, whatever. The show will continue. The show must go on. Mike, we love you, but F you. We're going to keep it rolling, homie.
Yeah, all right? Well, forget
about it. We got to do what we got to do.
The minute your car crosses state lines into Virginia or however the hell you're getting there, deuce, homie.
Yeah, but no, it's a great opportunity for somebody here in this building, too. So it's, you know, it's good for everybody.
Oh, look how selfless he is. Can you say what you're doing?
I mean, I'll be doing the same thing, just in another market.
A bigger market, a good opportunity.
You'll still be running into Josh now and then.
a warmer market. You'll be down in Florida producing a morning show down there. Your bank account will be a little bit fuller, and hopefully your life will be a little bit fuller, and you'll be able to accomplish and achieve a lot of the things you've always hoped to in life. Buy a house. Make an honest woman of your lady. Put a ring on that finger.
Well, let's not get crazy.
Retire with, you know, a nice chunk of change. And look, these are all things I've wanted for you. And sometimes life doesn't work out where you can make that happen here. And look, I had to move at one point. Spiegel has moved. We've all had to do these. It's the nature of the business sometimes. And it's a part of the business that sucks. But it is what it is, right, Speaks?
Yeah.
I mean, you've been there.
Yeah, I was telling Mike that I'm very proud
100%
that he's taking this risk, because, frankly, I didn't think he'd ever leave here, because I think he, not because he's not talented, he's amazing and, like you said, the greatest producer. I just didn't think he would take that risk, you know, because he's so quiet and reserved. Mm-hmm. I thought he would be here for a long time and, you know, never really leave the nest. So I'm very proud that Mike has the courage to take this risk, because in this business, you need to take risks. You need to move around. And it's an amazing opportunity. It's a very good company. It's a company where he can, you know, advance.
Yes.
There are incredible opportunities, incredible connections he's going to make. And look, it's a bittersweet thing, because I'm very happy for him, but it's really saddens me. And a couple of days ago, I was at home thinking about, I've been thinking about it a lot.
Yeah,
and I'm very sad. And
I'm sick of crying about this.
Yeah,
too, by
I was tearing up about it. I am right now.
If you look here,
Because I don't only consider, you know, I only know a handful of people. I know really the closest people in this town that I know are in this room. So you know, I not only consider Mike a colleague who's really been our right-hand man, right and left-hand man, for however many years, but he's like a friend, and
I dare say a brother.
Yes.
Oh, you're closer to me than blood relatives, brother. I've said the show is made up of four parts: Scott, you are the spine. Josh, you're the brains. Me, I'm the heart. But Mike, you're the soul. You're the soul of the show. The show is the way the show is because of you and your energy and abilities being at the center of it. You're a comfort blanket to me. I see you and I know that I have you back there, and I know the day will go better because I see you. And I know that any issues that might pop up, whether it be an audio issue, whether it be a guest issue, whether it be us needing to veer very suddenly. A lot of times you make this schedule and we'll decide to veer and you just go with it. And you've never once given us any guff. You've never once complained. You're the most selfless person I've ever worked with in any job. You're the most talented person, yes, I've ever worked with in any job. And I'm so happy for you that you're going. And the show is going to survive. The show will be fine. We got stuff in place that the show is going to be as good. It'll be better. It will always get better. All we ever seek to do is improve. But it will have a different flavor without you here. And I'm happy for you.
Well,
but it still sucks.
Yeah.
Come on, you got to say something.
Kath. Woo! All right, get it together, Mike.
Here, let me play an upbeat song. Let me play an upbeat song.
It's so entertaining.
Here we go. Here, go ahead, Mike. I don't like my mind right. Go ahead. By the way, this is the song that came on. Why did that day suck? What was the day that I find out?
I'm sorry, making it about you.
It's just a song comes
it's
on.
It's not about you.
The minute that I get the news, they say, hey, enjoy your new Friday night show. By the way, here's Linkin Park Heavy. Oh, we all Mr. Chester Bennington. I should have just had my cat walk in the room and die at the same time because it just sucked.
So yeah, Mike Anderson, the illustrious producer of 98 Rock, the man who tattooed his balls, the man that poured vodka in his eyes, the man that walked 44 miles to work. What else? I mean, you are the Forrest Gump of Baltimore. You have done and experienced and decided to partake in challenges, and you became a bodybuilder. I mean, what else have you? You've done just all of these amazing things and all on your own accord, never forced to do anything. In 11 years, the man has never missed one day of work here at the WBAL building. In 11 years.
Whatever. What year did you start? 11 years?
You're 12 years.
12 years.
2007.
2007.
Screw it. We'll go late. Mike, please.
He's one of the best producers in radio. I love him like a brother. He just a unique talent. Just an unbelievable person.
Well, to get through this, I've had to pretend that he's dying.
I think I have, too. I haven't really dealt with it much.
I've had to turn my sadness to hate for you.
But, yeah, congratulations to Mike Anderson. Yeah. Heading to Florida to take on some new roles down there. Yeah. But we'll be leaving this program. But we have somebody who has been hanging out the last couple of weeks, training, and is going to slide right in, and it'll be as seamless as possible. I've already been scoping this person out on the down low as to their movings in and out of the studio and what they're doing, and I'm very, very, very happy with what I see so far. So is it Mike Anderson? No, but it's, hey, look, you know.
Who is?
Mike, do you have anything to say?
Well, I mean, I couldn't have asked for a better show to, you know, kind of cut my teeth with, and you guys made it easy. You know, I think I was telling you, Scott, over the weekend, you know, this show is so good. You could go without a producer and still crush everybody else.
No chance. Not without you. Not without you.
So, you know, it's just an honor to be able to be a part of it for as long as I have.
Oh, man. Your last day is going to be an S show. Your last day.
So 2 weeks.
Can we say when your last day is?
Yeah, his last day will be the 15th.
You're going to have to leave today.
That's actually going to be our St. Patrick's Day bacon and beer.
Yeah, let's just say it now. We're going to do a St. Patrick's Day bacon and beer.
We'll do official announcement tomorrow, but just for all the details, 15th is his last day. We're actually going to be out broadcasting live, so let's make it a party.
Yeah, let's do it.
And we'll give you all the details tomorrow surrounding that, right at this time as well. So tomorrow, full details, St. Patrick's Day broadcast. Mike's last day here.
Ooh, Thompson had a great idea. We should have a funeral for him. We've got a casket.
Yes.
Oh, let's go to the traffic.
There are lots of ways to listen to 98 Rock every day. 97.9 FM, streaming live on 98online.com. The 98 Rock smartphone app on iPhone and Android, and on your Amazon Alexa and Google Home. Make sure to follow us on Facebook at facebook.com/98online.